what's up, beautiful people? Welcome back to the show. You're still watching Salute Talk right here on Urban TV. If you haven't caught up the conversation, you can still go back to our social media platforms, and guys, you can still get the clips of the show online. Yeah, so in the building, we are joined by a guy who's going to tell us his view, because now we were talking about what women go through and how we see men, but now he's going to tell us how they see women. Jebale Kosebo, how are you? How is your afternoon?
It's all good. How about you?
So, first, tell the people your name, and then we can start from there.
I go by name Zimla Leon.
So, Leon, let me just jump right into it. Do you have sex? Do you have a girlfriend?
I do have a girlfriend.
Okay. So has your girlfriend ever come to you now, Kugamba? Oh, we are expecting a child.
To be honest, yeah.
So now actually perfect. So are you a father or what you are? I would have been father. So okay, now that is actually perfect. What was running in your mind the first thing she told you? Oh, Leon, I'm pregnant. What was the first thing in your mind? Honestly speaking, what was the first thing that ran into your mind?
Maybe it wasn't. It's an experience I've been seeing most of the time. So by the time it came, I was well guided about it. So I didn't panic. I didn't do anything. So we got together and talked about it, and we sure resolved and got to the best final answer.
So that means you were there for her throughout everything.
Yeah.
Exactly. Kati, what do you say for your other fellow men? Like the when the girlfriend comes and tells them, oh, I'm pregnant, they always lash out at the person.
My best advice would be to act mature. A boat isn't the best solution, but there is a situation where you're going to give a child to that is going to just how should I call it? You don't have the best, you're not in the full capacity to take care of the kid. And then probably you to tell you, but that kid is just going to be seeing days. So our best solution would be to abort.
This is something. The country is against abortion. Don't you think you are ruining someone's future, someone's health, like healthy future? How about you stop being selfish and abstain from these girls if at all you are not ready to have kids?
My best answer would be that by maturity, I mean to come to the best conclusion. If I'm in full capacity to take care of a kid, obviously I wouldn't, and she's ready, obviously I'll tell her to give birth. But if I know I'm not ready, I wouldn't really want that kid to suffer plus the mom. So I know abortion ain't the right solution, but at the moment, that's the best solution at the moment.
So, if you're not ready, you mean you have to be selfish. If you're not ready to have a kid, you would rather be selfish. You'd rather go and enjoy the way you want to enjoy, and then at the end of it, oh man, I'm not ready and I'm not gonna sacrifice. If you're not ready, you'd rather be selfish than abstain.
If I'm not ready, I would rather protect than abstain.
What are you rather protect than abstain? But like we all know, it takes two to tango. And if we are to actually agree, abakazi webasiko wamera sex and abasajja, walai, no walai. If honestly speaking, no, men say they are the ones who enjoy, but it's actually supposed to be a woman's thing. If I'm to me, I'll be a feminist. And that sex supposed to be
it's
a woman.
It's actually 70-30.
I know, boss. It's 50-50. I can actually abstain for more than even 2 years if possible. Why I say this is for women is because Omsajia can have sex with anyone, and sex is not all about where you go in, come out. That's not about sex. Sex is everything: emotion, the love, the care, the romance. It's not just. And men just have sex just for justice because maybe he's horny or he has seen someone pretty. But a woman will have sex with someone who she actually cares about. Very many say women have sex for money, but then still, she has to at least be attracted to that person.
So I still disagree with you. Who is that someone you care about that doesn't care about you? If he doesn't care about your life to an extent of help abort, then he doesn't care about you. You cannot say you love me and you are to destroy my life.
You can never know.
That is not love.
To say that he loves you. Mm. That's why I said men are very good actors.
So, in other words, to get to know, let me ask, how do we get to know a man's true colors? Is it when you get pregnant first, or how do we get to know a man's true characters? Because if you say men are actors, then we definitely need to know how to get to know the actual characters.
Leon, you're a man, so first tell us, do men like what she's asked? Do men actually like what character are they to us?
It all comes back to the lady, yeah? It all comes back to the lady. So if I'm trying to give you my all, and
what is your all?
Like my all, remember, a relationship is all about reciprocating, you get? So if I'm trying to give you all my all, and you're giving me something partial,
yeah,
definitely I'm going to go and find some better solution or something else, you get? So by the time you realize I've been trying to show you, I've been giving you my all, and it's a bit late. You feel me? Yeah, it's a bit late, and that's when problems like cheating comes in. You're having two women at the same time because you both love them and you can't afford to lose them.
What if that's just the man's nature? Because if I'm to quote Steve Harvey, right? Steve Harvey Agamba, he said, a man who loves you is not determined by what he gives you, but what he sacrifices for you. You as Leon, what can you sacrifice for the person you love?
Everything.
What's everything? What's everything? Because men say everything. What is it? Because by the way, if a man says, if I pay your rent, if I buy you, if I take you to the saloon, if I do your nails, I'm giving you. What have you given me that is from you?
No, let me give you two examples of two guys, okay? So there is this guy, he's capable of paying for an apartment, and after paying for an apartment, he's still going to be able to afford to buy a car and everything. And there is a kind of guy that is going to pay for an apartment, but from his savings.
Yeah.
So, which of the two guys would you be meaning at the moment?
I'll take the one from
your savings. Yeah, cause that's a sacrifice.
No, let's be real. What if the savings get done? I'm just out of the apartment.
No, but fact, a guy that loves you gives you the best, gives you the best of his version. So I might be able to give you the apartment, but in actual sense I might even go beyond the apartment and give you your best car, your best life. But at the moment I'm just going to be giving you the apartment just to keep you there. But it doesn't mean I love you.
No, that's what they call sacrifice. But if we like Kampala people now, most of Kampala men, whenever they are looking for girls, and I'm going to say this because that is the blunt truth. When a man approaches a girl, most so now in a bar, in a restaurant, very many women, they don't go to restaurants because they're going to eat. Baba against a kwetega. Is it the word here? Baba against a kwetega. So most men, actually, when they approach these ladies, they do not give them a chance to explain themselves. Not every girl that you see puts on skimpy, that you see is putting on classes, that you see is on national TV. Not every girl you see is like everybody else. Just like how the same way, not every man you see is like everybody else. So this guy approaches this girl. Ngatana anamubuza about her or what she likes or what she doesn't like. Amubuliza okutwale wange meka ka 200k. So we are all having that thing of women now want money, men now want women who want money, like atamuwa stress, like men don't want to court anymore. They don't want to court. They just want to...
Remember I told you earlier, there's something in a pipeline, there's a project I'm working on that is going to help girls in that particular situation. The fact that girls... But to kaku extend a yoga and okwetega somewhere just to get like a 200k. How about if you earn the 200k in the right ways? How about if you make like a 200k even more than kusabiriza moto?
There is a girl I asked Namuvuza about the situation. A girl that actually does that. Omaiche has the mian number after tulipa kwa unawe. Kati kati zengende nkole nkole.
So we need to take away that thing. We need to bash that whole thing to... You can actually get your own money. We do not. By the way, let me tell you, if it wasn't for marriage and giving birth, sometimes we don't need men. We don't.
True.
We don't
actually
need men.
Speaking, men, Man, I've talked to very many friends of mine, male friends, that have actually told me they value almost, or like they value a lady that actually works. No, but often a cent, like, let me say you go to your workplace and they don't pay you enough money to take care of you. But they value a woman who wakes up in the morning, nana, banayambala, nagana, nakola. Very many men, some of us be like, ah, zenyagala musa magana okumpa ulichimu. What are you going to give him? Because women think, okay, fine, the guy is going to give me everything, then I'm going to give him sex. They're also not benefiting from the sex that we're giving because they can get it from anyone else. What are you adding? If you're working, and let me say, you are working and you're actually earning your money, no matter how small it is, the man will always give you the respect that he's supposed to give you.
Media personalities, I don't want to mention, have gotten the courage. They are, I'm sorry to say stupid, but let me just, you too. They are becoming stupid to disrespect women and taking them as sex objects. You get my point? See, it is okay for a girl to date someone who is actually beyond your father's age, just in the name of money. Can you imagine going to your family, and you find your mother kneeling down for such a man?
We are coming to the end of the show, and I want to get to the final conclusions of now what you people think. So I'll start with the guy. I'll start with you, Leon. Have you ever been there and you meet a lady in Ogamba? I just want to sleep with her. And then have you also ever met another woman go Ogamba? Oh, or Nyagala Muwasa?
Definitely facts. Yeah, it's 100%.
So now, what are your reasons to all that?
To the kind of woman Gwenjagala Okuwasa. She's the kind of woman Gwalabanti Yanaja Kutuara you get. So there is this kind of woman you see her. She's all about social media, I'm saying. She's all about that life. And you really can't afford that, you get. So there is this kind of woman that is going to understand you for who you are and give you that time for developing yourself, should I say. That's the kind of woman suitable for a relationship.
So you go with who can understand you more. Okay, so Lisa, let me come to you.
We are all humans. We have emotions, we have feelings, we get attracted to people. But I think I'm at the point where I'm not doing that. Okay, I believe when I was younger, maybe I would do something like that.
But of course, you have ever been there. No,
yeah, but at this point right now, I'm going to look at a guy and I feel like, I'll actually just say it in my head, oh my God, that guy looks fine. I think he would. But then I'm not going to go. I'm not really going to go for that because I feel like I'm not at that age anymore. If I have someone, I feel like this is my man. I feel like there are a lot of factors that make me feel like I want to settle with a man. Like a man maybe I have right now, maybe I'm committed to it because I have reasons. I have those things I look at and I feel like I can be with this man. But right now at this age, okay, I'm not doing those things anymore. No, I am okay. I'm not doing that anymore. So we're adding my people here and there, but then you leave it at that because at the end of the day, beautiful people are everywhere, handsome men are everywhere, but you can't just go on sleeping with everyone. Yeah, you just get to a point where you leave things at that.
So last but not least, baby mama, before you met our hubby, I know right now you're contented. There is no question of asking you beyond that. Before you met him, I'm very sure you've ever met like such a type of guy, go Gamba, or just to appear, like just for one day or even like a week and you just move on. Have you ever been there, no, on like with those feelings?
Surprisingly, I've not. And I used to be a very jumpy girl. Everyone knows, even my workmates know. I used to be very, very, very jumpy. Me, I'm a person that goes for love. Since day one, all my exes, like I've always been, it has always been love, nothing else. Yeah,
there
is feelings involved. Yeah, there's feelings involved. The wali no kamulia.
There are some stories that don't remember how. I'll just tell them go. Anyway, guys, we have not talked about everything. We have not exhausted everything, but the show is still running. It's running every Sunday. So guys, make sure you're tuned into Urban TV to catch up the latest gossip, the latest trends. And if you have questions that I've always wanted answers for, this is the show for you. I'm your girl, Shabaya Hughes, aka Wild and Free. We shall catch you up next Sunday.